I'm serious about my cereals. What type I'm consuming, making sure I try every single one, all of it. On workout days, I eat cereals with a lot of carbs and grains because it might help me lift my 15-pound dumbbells more easily. On non-workout days, I'm eating cereals which are low-carb to keep it lean. I think that's how it works. And I've tried so many grain-free cereals that I've had to throw out. No joke. My immigrant parents would not be happy to hear this, but the ingredients in them create a real hard cereal and they do not soften up. Again, I'm not kidding. I've tried letting them soak for like 20 minutes and still, it was like shoving a spoonful of rocks into my mouth. I had to toss them. My curiosity has led me away from Magic Spoon, but I'm going back because it has what I need and it tastes great. Magic Spoon has 0 grams of sugar, 13 to 14 grams of protein, and only 4 net grams of carbs per serving, which are only 140 calories each. It's keto-friendly, gluten-free, grain-free, soy-free, and low-carb. You can build your own box of tasty flavors. I've tried them all. Custom bundles can be built with cocoa, fruity, frosted, peanut butter, blueberry, cinnamon, cookies and cream, and maple waffle. Cookies and cream and maple waffle were first introduced for a limited time, but they sold out extremely quickly, so they are back permanently in the starting lineup. Go to magicspoon.com/nodunks to grab a custom bundle of cereal and try it today. And be sure to use our promo code NODUNKS at checkout to save $5 off your order. Magic Spoon is so confident in their product, it's backed with a 100% happiness guarantee. If you don't like it for any reason, they'll refund your money, no questions asked. Remember, get your next delicious bowl of guilt-free cereal at magicspoon.com/nodunks and use the code NODUNKS to save $5. Thank you, Magic Spoon, for sponsoring this episode and for saving my teeth.
I'm kind of in remorse. I need a wedgie pretty badly.
Hey, welcome to No Dunks. I'm Tess, here with Skeets, Trey, Lee, and JD, of course. We are here for part two of our top 75 guests in the history of this show. Part one was fun.
It was a blast.
I'm glad you said that.
I really enjoyed myself. I was like, oh yeah, we talked to that person. Oh yeah, that was a fun time.
Yeah, good. We're feeling it. Yeah, Lee shot around with Steph. Yanis gave me the business because I called him overrated. We had a Shaq Chuck moment. Actually, Shaq will be in part three. He's giving you a wedgie in part three.
Spoiler.
Lots to look forward to. But let's get into part two of our top 75 guests with our first 10. Roll it, JD.
First thought. There is a bit of a loophole here. I could just sit here and say absolutely nothing.
That's not you.
But yeah, that's not me. You've done a show way too long with me. I can't keep my mouth shut. So well played on that task. Second thought, as I speed up here.
Slow down,
I have
man.
No idea why. Why am I rushing?
Got him.
Fox. We need a fifth starter,
yeah,
man.
Hold on, yeah, man. Yeah, 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 yeah,
we probably should have unbuttoned
him.
While he struggles to put on a shirt.
The buttons are tough.
Channing, what's going through your mind right now?
Number one. Holy shit. I'm sorry for the cuss words, but
we got bleeps.
Bleep me, you're gonna be bleeping out a lot.
Cherry Greenberg. Cherry Greenberg. Cherry Greenberg, Cherry Greenberg. Cherry Greenberg.
Wow. What a pack of 10 that was.
That's gonna be stuck in my head for weeks. Just got it out of my head.
The Jerry Greenberg theme. How did that come about? I guess it was just JD going through the music library and just finding that.
Well, there was, wasn't there this weird, like, Was it an app?
I found it on, yeah. I think, Fans Since 09. Created the original, which was, Yeah, Man's a Bird,
right.
The Monday Night Football theme song.
Yeah.
It was created with whatever the app was called, Diddy, I believe, D-I-T-T-Y. Uh-huh. Not to be confused with the rap mogul. But yeah, for whatever reason, Yeah, Man's a Bird, Jared Greenberg, they line up perfectly. So a banger.
That was a hit. Anytime we would have Greenberg on, you know, usually he'd be out of game, so we'd have him on like satellite and stuff like that. But once we had that theme song, like, people were demanding it.
Yeah,
like,
he was demanding it.
He was. Yeah. You're right. That's a good point, and it's I can see why it's still so catchy.
Our best theme song of anyone. We'll get to some more here as our top 75 go on in part three, but that one really stands out. That was a great one. On the music tip, that Sir Foster pick and payoff. He came down, the Hawks organist came into our studio and played music every time you spoke.
Yeah, so that was the payoff. Anytime I spoke,
yeah, it's to throw you off. You know, he's so good down at the Hawks game. Dan, 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 dan. Like every time.
Well, you notice there in the clip, like I did start speeding up.
Yeah.
He's like, he's speeding it up, and I'm like getting anxious. That's a very
I loved how he got into it so much. You see you there, and he's like really trying to like put you off. And by the way, you look like you're about 6 years old in that clip.
Yeah,
much younger, the young boy.
Clean Skeets.
Oh my God. Yeah.
Holy moly.
JD was ready for this. Absolutely.
Yeah. Oh man. I don't think I have that shirt anymore either. I gained some pounds in the upper body too. It's getting a little too tight. My favorite thing with the Sir Foster payoff though is like we basically have like a running inside joke from him being on the show, and it's a weird one. But this is the point of this, right? To peel back the curtain.
Yes, absolutely.
To let our fans know. So anytime we're about to do a show, about to go live, for you know here in the Classic Factory or when we were the starters on NBA TV, if you have to go piss before the show.
Yes.
We call that a Sir Foster.
Yes.
And the reason is only because right before we were about to go live with Sir Foster doing the, you know, tinkling the ivory is what he did. Tinkling the porcelain. He had to like take, he was like, we're about to go live. He's like, I got to go to the bathroom. Like, I got to go to the restroom real quick.
Yeah.
And did, and it was fine and got back in time. But for some reason, we call it taking a Sir Foster.
Yeah.
So there you go.
And it extends to anywhere now. Like before you catch a flight, it's like, oh, I got a Sir Foster.
I got a Sir Foster. Yeah.
The last second tinkling of the porcelain.
It's actually it's a nicer way to say it because I always say, and my wife gets upset with me, Nora gets mad when I always say, like, oh, I got to take a piss.
Yeah.
She hates that. She's like, don't say that out loud. Like, so take a Sir Foster.
She knows what a Sir Foster is.
Absolutely.
When I was in England doing the show from my brother's apartment, I said to him, I just got to go do a Sir Foster. And I told him about it. Now he uses that term with his friends.
See, it's going to spread. I'm telling you.
It sounds British, too. Yeah. I mean, it's the most proper way of saying
it. He was knighted. Yeah, but he had to go right before he got his knighted.
Well, he was locked in. He had his headphones in.
Right.
And I remember, it was 2 minutes before
we were
time.
Just about to go live. Like it was really close.
Maybe he didn't think it was live.
Maybe not, because I remember we were like, are you gonna be able to get back in time? Like, but he did, and he killed it. He's the best. We see him down obviously at the Hawks game. And like, I guess it shouldn't be a surprise that he could do it so well on live television to play the piano whenever I was talking, because that's what he's doing during an NBA game. Like he has to play to the action and stuff like that. So
but
it was great.
But he was so good.
Oh, he was. He was.
I thought it was a little surprising. We actually have another clip. Let's roll it, JD.
I know it's supposed to undermine me.
Look at that.
I know it's supposed to, like, get me off my game. But what if it just makes everything I say sound awesome?
Very inspirational.
Sounds awesome. Sounds awesome. Get the shots up. It's the moving around with the ball skills, and it's just going to take a little bit while. What about Russell Westbrook? That was sort of the little. It's really phenomenal stuff. But let's move on. More basketball games to talk about here last night.
Sir Foster, are you cool coming down every show?
This feels so good.
The thumbs up. What a pro,
it's
man.
It's like when Ross Geller and Friends unleashes his tunes and they all hate him, but he was just like getting so into it like that. Bit of a Friends reference. I don't know if you remember.
I can't believe we didn't like take that payoff
and then run with it for another one and have him play the saxophone during a show where we were talking. That would be more difficult to yell over a saxophone. Because he can play that instrument, right? For sure. Mm-hmm. He probably can play every instrument.
Let's get him in the classic factory and see what he brings down.
Just
down the street.
Get him and Bones. Bones can be on the guitar and a little jam.
Just jam. Cool.
One moment I had forgotten about was the deer and fox moment we showed there.
Yeah.
We handed several of our Summer League guest shirts, if I do remember correctly.
I don't know.
I don't remember those ones.
We definitely gave him cakes.
Yeah.
And maybe that was a one of one because it went so poorly. We handed him a shirt that was fully buttoned up and was very difficult to unbutton. Yeah. It's cringeworthy watching it back that he has to sit there. He's a very smiley guy. He's very happy and he smiles through it, shockingly. But he's like, struggling because they're
why
they're
were we
like,
giving it to him?
It said on the lower third, how much would it cost for you to wear this starter shirt? Wow. I don't know, we were just making fun of the shirts that we were wearing, I guess. Those were some shirts.
Yeah. Those were the mechanic shirts.
Those were the mechanic shirts. Yeah.
Yes.
I don't remember. I remember the yellows. I remember other variations. I don't remember those bright blues.
The blues, yeah.
Yeah.
If you could track one of those down, it'd be great for worst shirt week.
All of those would be a week long.
That was every summer league week we were there.
I remember there's a fan, I won't reveal who it is right now, who always wanted my mechanic shirt at the end of summer league. I sent him a few.
Yeah, all right. What are you going to do with them? Yeah.
Yeah. And he was like, yep, great.
All right.
See if he's got a blue one.
Yeah.
I like that we can't name this person.
Cannot say it.
No.
Definitely.
Lots of great Summer League moments, great All-Star moments. We had Pau and Marc Gasol there together. We interviewed them in New York City together. I remember, Trey, you had a pre-show conversation with Marc Gasol, or is that a post-show conversation? Do you remember that?
I think he had just had a daughter not too long before, and I remember there was a picture going around of Marc Gasol, like, sitting in an anthropology, just, like, waiting, just waiting in an anthropology. That was, like, the most relatable thing I've ever seen. So, yeah, you know, I at the time, Isla would have been, like, 4 months old. So, you know, just a little classic dad chats. Mm. Obviously, he's a family man. Him and Pau up there rearranging our chairs for us in between commercial breaks. Those are good guys.
Yeah, here's another relatable moment. We'll show you a clip from the Gasols. This is relatable for you guys. Here's a clip, Mark and Pau Gasol.
Oh, interesting.
Mark's had it.
What do we got?
Pau, turn it around. Being late.
Being late. I mean, it's word for word.
Wow.
Why
are you always late?
I'm not always late. I'm always late. I'm sometimes late.
We were supposed to have you on the show that
seems
we did
like
earlier.
This
is one of the times that I've been late.
Yes, we were waiting for them, and they happened to be late. And Mark, not happy with Pau. Not happy with Pau that he's always late. That was a great in sync moment. You see them turn their heads together. Yeah. NBA in sync. That was great.
Mm-hmm. Mm. That was pretty cool that we had them on at the same time. Because they made history that weekend,
right? Yeah.
Obviously, doing the jump ball in the All-Star game. Pretty neat.
Yeah. Yes. We've had some moments. You have been in the locker room. Probably one of your most cherished moments doing the starters.
No doubt, yeah.
For the Cavs.
Game 7, 2016. My second child, Ada, was due to be born a few days before, and Laura said, she'd be fine. Just fly across country. And she was right. And it was totally worth it. Hanging in the locker room was incredibly fun. Talking to all the guys, seeing how surprisingly excited they were to see somebody from the starters, which I thought was super cool. And there was a great moment with Channing Frye where we actually found out the last time J.R. Smith was wearing his shirt. Take a look.
What's you feeling right now?
What's you feeling right now, boy?
I'm feeling great.
We got you carded up here, Channing.
No, you don't.
And we're out.
What happened to your shirt, though, Channing?
Gave it away.
Oh, okay.
So what's up for the rest of the night? You gonna hop in that Uber pool and just jet around here in Oakland?
Hell no! I don't know where we going, but we not staying in Oakland, I'm gonna tell you that, or San Francisco. I know Cleveland's gonna be popping when we get back.
That's for sure.
What?
It was having a great time. Yeah. I know there's some moments in that that set of clips where he's shirt off, arm around me. And that's a tall guy. Like, you don't think of Channing Frye as a 7-footer, right. But I was nose to pit with him. But respect. The funny thing, though, is that J.R. Smith clip, people pulled that out much later because, like, that whole summer, right, he was never wearing a shirt.
Yeah.
And everybody's like, oh, he found out to not wear a shirt from Channing Frye. He's like, hey, where's your shirt go? I don't know. All right, fine. I'll pop mine off. Let's go.
And then the next layer is that Channing Frye realized he just gave away his shirt like Lee gave away his shirt. That
might have been the same guy.
That's the link.
Guy.
Yeah, maybe it is, for all we know. Yeah, that's, I'm always like, I'm not jealous is not the right word, but to me, when you see any of these clips of you guys anytime in the locker room, especially after a title, and they're just like the happiest they could be, and they're putting back beers, and they're like, oh, it's just the best.
Oh, yeah.
It's pretty cool. And it's like, on top of that, that they obviously recognize who you were and stuff like that in the show.
Yeah.
NBA TV is on a lot right. around NBA arenas, no doubt about it. So when you're on at that 6 o'clock time slot, they got nothing to do.
Right before the game, guys are getting taped up and stuff, doing
captive
stretches.
Audience.
Yep. Yeah, there were several guys complimenting the show in your clip there. Did you find it hard to criticize guys after they said, hey man, I love the show? Because I would. I mean, you like me, like, can you, I would have it pretty difficult for the next year. I'd give it a year and then I can start, you know.
Oh yeah, I'm like still the biggest Kyrie Irving fan in the world.
Gotta do it.
Yeah, do whatever you want, buddy. He was super nice to me.
Exactly.
All the rest of the media is pawns, not us.
One last thing I wanted to highlight in that 10 pack that JD, the little montage of our 10 guests there, was a clip of me and Rip Hamilton at a flat top in a kitchen, totally staged shot of a huge flame coming at myself, Rip Hamilton, and Corbren Maxwell also in that clip.
Wow.
Yeah, really strange. We were in London. Now, I that was very funny. We also had him on the show, so it wasn't a total force because Rip was in our studio.
Oh, right.
A little bit later, he didn't like that I brought up that LeBron had 25 straight against him in the Pistons in 2007, but I didn't want to highlight that. I also want to highlight, I happened to be having tea a little bit later with John Amici, Brian Scalabrine,
yep.
Dikembe Mutombo, and Andre Miller, and I didn't have a mic on. And this is a clip of the director coming in, cutting it, and Andre Miller is hilarious. Have a watch.
I would like to welcome Taz from The Starters to our afternoon tea.
Thank you so much. Sorry. Actually, I have that mic.
I didn't realize Taz is on the
mic. Bam, Taz.
Hey.
Oh. Hey. That's a fine task.
Yeah, you can.
You know the rules, Taz.
You don't think of Andre Miller as a hilarious guy.
That's funny, man.
Did we play that in the show or something?
Yeah,
we did.
Oh, we did. There was a medley.
Awesome.
Yeah, yeah.
It was a quick medley because it was a quick tea session that we had that John Amici was hosting that I happened to jump into with Brian Scalabrine. I had no idea. I just got off a red-eye flight. Hey, you're having tea with John Amici, Brian Scalabrine. It was just...
You're not the host in it, are you?
No, John Amici
That's
is.
The most fascinating part to me.
Just right. a guest.
It would make way more sense if, like, Taz was the host with all these former NBA players, but, like, yeah, you're just suddenly there.
It's the Brit. John Amici hosting all of his NBA legends that were there for the game in London in 2018. And
you're a legend.
It was a, hey, this guy is here for NBA TV, put him in, but don't give him a mic. So that was hilarious.
Yeah, that's what one of my, like, a sneaky favorite part of that clip is, like, the producer or somebody realizes you don't have a mic, and it feels like you're like, you knew you didn't have
a mic
on. You're like, yeah, I don't have a mic, like, right away.
Was that the plan?
Because
I can understand if you just want to hear Dikembe Mutombo talk, and maybe I'm just a seat filler here.
You're just a seat filler. Somebody's going to drink this tea. That was a fun trip, though, overall, right? Going over to
amazing.
England to watch a game, yeah.
Yeah, it was phenomenal. It was great.
And you said the fire, like, little clip there with Rip Hamilton, that was, like, just planned?
It was staged, yeah.
Staged?
Yeah.
Wow. So why? Just to get a cool reaction?
Just to get a shot.
Wow.
Yeah, we used it. I think we used it 3 times that week in our shows. We used it a lot.
Did it make the meme team? It probably did.
It
number
made
4.
The meme team. Definitely made a show opening.
I love it.
That's a great shot.
Yeah, it is.
I think I saw Gordon Ramsay right after that. What a moment for me.
Wow.
Exactly.
Guy Fieri and Gordon Ramsay.
And then, are there
multiple takes, do you think, of the reactions? or did you nail it on the first one? I think we killed it.
Rip killed it. And Rip and Cornbread Maxwell made a beef Wellington that morning. And
listen to what you're saying.
I know. And then Rip was on our show years later. And we were talking about the beef Wellington that he went home and tried to recreate the beef Wellington. And it was too difficult.
It is a tough one.
Yeah, it's tough. Well, it's tough, right?
Well, it's tough to cook, yeah. Yeah, you got to get the pastry around the beef and then get it right. And yeah, you got to be high-level chef, I think, to nail that.
Yeah, it's like a landmark if you're a chef, right? To be able to make a beef Wellington.
That's one of the tests. I think it's a test.
Went home. He's like, man, that was good. I wonder if I could do that at home.
It was damn good. In England. Yeah. It was amazing. Because it was Gordon Ramsay's restaurant, but he couldn't recreate it, unfortunately. Mm-hmm.
Did when the flame kicked up on that stage shot, did Cornbread get burnt a little bit? Or?
Very well done. All right. We will get to our next 10 after this break. One of the clips is Ernie Johnson welcoming the starters to the basketball world in a hilarious fashion. Stay tuned.
Listen, with HelloFresh, you get farm fresh, pre-portioned ingredients and seasonal recipes delivered right to your doorstep. Forget about those trips to the grocery store and count on HelloFresh to make home cooking easy, fun, and affordable. That's why it's America's number one meal kit. I love it because it takes all the dicking around about trying to decide what to have for dinner. A little confession here. I actually pick the meals myself, but I tell my family it's a surprise. So they think that HelloFresh is curating this box of food for us, but it's actually me making all the decisions, and it works out great for me. That's a dad hack for you. HelloFresh is 72% cheaper than a restaurant meal of the same quality, and you can save on average over $65 per month when you order HelloFresh instead of grocery shopping. HelloFresh offers 50 menu and market items to choose from every week, including veggie, calorie smart, family friendly, and gourmet options, providing plenty of variety. Recipes like hibachi sweet soy bavette steak and shrimp.
Holy wow. That sounds decadent.
It does sound decadent. Put it in a quiche. Bring restaurant quality meals right to your kitchen, while their white cheddar wonder burgers make it easier than ever to skip the takeout. And honestly, it's a great way to get your kids cooking. You can do it with them if they're younger, but I just make my kids make dinner. The step-by-step instructions are all laid out. It's super easy to follow, and it gets them off making meals like instant ramen and Kraft dinner. To be honest, when I make dinner, that's what we're having, the instant ramen and Kraft dinner. Go to HelloFresh.com/NoDunk16. And use code NODUNKS16, that's 1-6, for up to 16 free meals and 3 free gifts. That's HelloFresh.com/NODUNKS16 and use code NODUNKS16 for up to 16 free meals and 3 free gifts.
It's a lot of free there.
Mm-hmm. It's a lot of free.
Yeah.
This next ad comes to you from a company that's cooking the best omelets you'll have all year, all while changing the world one egg at a time. It's called Just Egg, and I'm happy to tell you about it, because Just Egg is a cholesterol-free, plant-based egg that will give you the most decadent quiches of your life, the fluffiest scrambles, and the easiest egg sandwiches. Or in my case in particular, I love a good Just Egg scramble in the morning on an English muffin, a little bit of cheese and beautiful barbecue sauce. I think it's fantastic and it tastes great. And Just Egg has about the same protein as a chicken egg, but with much less saturated fat. Plus, Just Egg is packed with cholesterol-lowering polyunsaturated fat. Chicken eggs have severe FOMO when they look at Just Egg, and that's really the important part for me. In order for Just Egg to be successful, I think it really needs to make sure that it tastes good and is good for you, and I can happily say it ticks both of those boxes. As someone who loves eating eggs every morning, I've had to cut it back in recent years, basically because of health concerns. There's a lot of cholesterol in regular eggs, but I'm excited to have found an alternative that is good for me and good for the environment. In 2022, may your eggs be filled with Just Egg. Just Egg, really good eggs.
I love orange. I think everybody knows that. I've got the orange water bottle. I wear orange jackets. Had the orange microphone cover when we were recording from home, and I've basically been an orange man since 8th grade graduation. So when I first went to Indochino.com, I immediately searched for orange. And one of the first things I saw was a Clementine micro gingham casual shirt. This is from the description. The odds are you don't have a micro gingham shirt in this ripe, spring-ready shade of orange we call Clementine. And I think that's right. Most people probably don't have an orange micro gingham shirt, but honestly, you should. And maybe this year, you should let Indochino take care of your 2022 style edit. Because with Indochino, you can customize everything from suits and shirts to chinos and bomber jackets at prices more affordable than you might expect. Indochino offers completely custom fitted suits, shirts, casual wear, and more, so you can get a wardrobe personalized to your style and taste, for instance, orange-centric, without spending a fortune. Every piece is made to your exact measurements, and you can customize every detail. Suits start at $429, and shirts start at $79, and all customizations are included, so you can really go orange wild on this. Give yourself a style edit that sets the tone for the rest of the year with Indochino. Get $50 off any purchase of $399 or more by using promo code NODUNKS at Indochino.com. That's $50 off any purchase of $399 or more at INDOCHINO.com, promo code NODUNKS.
Hey, how excited are you guys that the starters have become the newest members of the NBA TV family?
Poutine.
There it is. Yes. Right. There it is.
And I must confess, I said it the wrong way one time to my mother-in-law. Mm. So I learned to make sure
it's poutine. Poutine. Yeah.
That was a big shot.
Yeah, it was a huge shot, some would say.
Man, I meditated on that, of being in that type moment and taking advantage of it. But I'm just glad it went in and I could celebrate.
The starter. Yeah, that's right. Come
on. I know, his beard is blazing. Shout out to your team too, the starters, man. Real talk, I love your show, man.
Kyrie's good in our books.
That's right.
I like that he said he meditated on that show. I don't remember him saying it in that clip.
Yeah, I don't remember that either. But now, like, I mean, 6 years after the fact, I'm like, he probably did meditate on that.
100%.
No doubt about that. Also, what a compliment. Oh, this beard is brazy. good times.
Oh, there's some good stuff in that package there. Andre Iguodala as well. He basically learned about us not being on NBA TV anymore, that we were let go. Mm. And then he said, oh, I'm sorry to hear about you guys leaving the network.
Best of luck in the future. I know y'all getting canceled. I'm sorry to hear that. When I retire, I may bring the show back when I run the channel.
Very good. Very good moment.
Yeah, I was super nervous for that interview because I think Lee had a prickly interaction with him at a previous final stop at some point, and then he was super nice about it. That being said, he hasn't retired yet, so
he's still waiting for the call. Yeah, we can take him up on that. Yeah. We have changed jobs, but he hasn't started a network yet.
He hasn't started a network yet either.
He's got time. Yeah. He's got time. You said you were like a little nervous though, but I mean, it's his demeanor too, right?
Exactly. His demeanor just in general, he's like a sarcastic guy in general. So whatever. We finished the interview. He's very nice about how everything ended at NBA TV. And then afterwards, he's like, I'm not that bad of a guy, right? However, it had gotten back to him that I was a little nervous and was like asking around, like, ooh, is he going to be okay with this? Is he trying to talk to me? It was fine. Oh, and it was funny. Great. It was very funny.
He's a cool dude. Yeah. So that was towards the end of our run at NBA TV, at the beginning of our run. Let's play the whole clip. Okay. This is Ernie Johnson and a lot of legends sitting around him welcoming us to the NBA TV world.
Hey, how excited are you guys that the starters have become the newest members of the NBA TV family?
What's the starters?
What's the starters, Ernie?
They're out of Canada, right?
It's EJ Skeets and Taj Mahal or something like that.
Oh, the old basketball. I can't say that, copyright.
The basketball.
So you're familiar with
starters?
I'm not familiar with them.
Me either.
I don't know who they are either.
Really? What other star? Yeah. Come on. What are we talking about?
Canada gets no respect.
I never lived. Bahamas, right, Rick?
Yeah, I'm from the Bahamas. What's that got to do with Canada?
I think our 6 years peaked right there. Yeah, day one. Too.
What a spot.
Yeah. That was really good.
How do you think they film that? Did they tell everybody? Like, Chuck doesn't really actually know what's going on, probably, right?
Doubt it.
I think he's like legit reacting to what are we talking about?
They all are.
They all are?
But what about Rick Fox?
They fed Fox the line. They had to.
I don't think they did. I think they only told Ernie literally 2 seconds before in his ear. It was Jeremy Levin. Yeah.
But there's no way Rick Fox said, the basketball. Oh, can't say it. That's copyright.
He may have.
I think he did not know the copyright issues.
No chance.
He didn't.
Come on. We wrote a script for it, guys.
I wrote a script.
There's no way he knew the Lou Adler fact that Lou Adler had the right to the basketball joke.
Maybe he's in on the legal side.
I think it's a bit of both. I think Trey is Charles right. There definitely was a script, but there was many of those guys sitting there had no clue what the hell they were recording.
Yes.
And were just reacting in real time, like, what are we talking about? Who are we talking about? And of course, Ernie's killing it with the EJ Skeets, and like, we wrote all that. But it's funnier than I remember. The shots of just guys sitting there.
Totally.
I love that.
Yeah. They would have known. Don't worry about saying anything to Charles. Let his natural reaction take over, Kenny. But they needed to have at least one person in on it.
And so they gave Rick Fox the actor
exactly,
of the group.
Exactly. Yeah. And you can tell Rick, he delivered the line beautifully there. So. Yeah.
And he's Canadian. He was the only one. I don't think anybody else.
I'm going to stand by him. I don't think. Listen. First of all, Rick Fox is the most connected Hollywood person in that room.
Mm-hmm. So nothing more Hollywood than
that. And I go on. I'm sure that he knew that we were coming on. Like, of all of those guys in that room, he knew that we were coming on.
All the guys in the room,
the guy was on Jake and Amir. He knew about us for sure.
We definitely had a few hits when we were working at the score with NBA TV. So it's not like some of those guys in the studio who are working at the NBA TV desk doing the nightly show. Saw our stuff. That's where the classic
What About Some Raptor News came from. That was Kenny Smith. Yeah.
But come on. The Basketball Jones copyright. Can't say that.
He's an actor. See, I will push back. I don't remember us writing that line. That part I definitely didn't. Yeah.
Or the EJ Skeets and Taj Mahal. I don't remember that.
We did that.
That was written.
We did that part.
I mean, it's natural.
Yeah. Anything we did with Ernie was basically gold.
Bangers.
Like, we went, 3 for 3, 4 for 4? Like, any sort of little funny video we ever did with him, be it that, and we had never even met the guy up until that point. And then the Red Zone, NBA Red Zone was hilarious. And then I forgot about the one where, I guess it was because Players Only started getting a broadcast, and the joke was going to be that Ernie was out of a job now, because not a former player, and it's going to all of them. And so then he was sliding over in the NBA TV like rankings to then do our show, and then I was out of a job, and we did that funny little video.
That's it. What is going on here?
It's Players Only. It's back, so I kind of get bumped from that studio. So I guess we could call it the ripple effect.
That's ridiculous. You know what, Ernie? I got a neato stat for you. Go f yourself. Presented by Skeets.
Hey. who'd like to start wearing bow ties?
Yes, indeed.
He just was so hilarious. Yep. He's great. Like delivering the line, so it's great.
Pro's pro, baby.
He's a goat for a reason. Yep.
One other tie-in. JD's favorite guest, Trey Skeets. You loved Wendell Holland being on our show.
Yeah.
Former Survivor contestant. No video of him because that was in a no video zone of our show. Ty and we recently got this desk that we're sitting at right now, made by the hands of Wendell Holland and his Beeve company.
We in Atlanta, about to deliver this this podcasting table to the No Dunks podcast. Check out these legs.
Oh, we're so ready for this table. We've been banging on the ping pong table.
That ping pong table goes with the decor, though. I mean,
oh, that's all right. So, what are we talking here, man?
Oh, this is oak.
Looking good.
Part of it.
Yeah, got to put the beef. Yeah, I like it.
And we have a sign that says "No Dunks" as the finishing touch.
Has anybody looked for a hidden immunity idol within the desk yet?
Oh, I've been over that thing.
That'd be amazing.
Haven't found anything yet.
I
didn't check the front. You never know.
Yeah, maybe actually, if you unscrew this, it might be tucked away inside.
Right?
Then. Yeah.
Gotta check everything.
Yeah.
Yeah. That is pretty funny though. That someone that won Survivor came on our show for one. That was cool. And then two made our desk that we're sitting at here.
Mm-hmm.
It's awesome.
One other thing I wanted to bring up, Grant Hill, multiple time guest on our show.
Mm-hmm.
I believe multiple times told that story about the poutine as well.
Right.
Which
got to be careful.
Got to be careful with Tamia's parents.
Right. He didn't know how to pronounce it at first.
Yeah.
Said
which
poutine.
I guess. He did.
To his mother-in-law.
Can I get some of that tasty poutine? I'm just saying that to your mother-in-law.
11 seconds.
Yeah.
Very fun.
That's great. And I love when we're watching back the package of it and we see Bernard King explaining how most people, when they spin on their toes.
Yeah.
But there's less friction if you spin on your heels.
Yeah. Hey,
so just do this for me. Just do this for me. Would
you like to feel that? And I think we're all like,
oh yeah.
You can feel it. You can feel the friction, the extra friction. But I don't know. Around my house now, when I got on like a pair of socks or something, I love to spin on my heel and I just like, just keep going.
You go faster.
Woo!
He's right.
He's right.
He's less control though. Less control.
Yeah. Less control.
Yeah. Good point. You're a little quicker, but you're...
Can't stop.
Just keep spinning.
Yeah.
Do you ever use it in your pickup runs? The old King spin there on
no,
the
No, I'm not posting up a whole lot in my pickup runs now. I'm three-point line to three-point line, but, you know, I'd like to try it out just to see.
We should do a video where we just test
exactly.
it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah.
It's like what was that show on ESPN? Like Sports Science or something like that?
Yeah.
We can, like, time it, like, how quick we can get our turnaround jumpers off, spinning on our heels to our toes.
That was a good show.
It was a great show.
Jason Capone got a shot off in .22, I think.
Crazy stuff.
I remember that. Yeah.
One other thing you remember is Buddy Hield at Summer League throwing a cake into the crowd.
Legendary moment in
I
my
can't
mind.
Believe this happened. I still can't believe this happened. Let's roll it, JD.
We got a special gift for you here.
We give everyone a cake.
Yeah.
Oh, look at this cake.
Y'all want some?
Yeah.
Give it to them.
I didn't remember that we really had to convince him to do it much. In my head, I thought it was like, he's just like, should I throw it? And we're like, probably like, yeah. And then he just chucked it, but it took some convincing.
Oh, yeah. You guys had to talk him into it. It was basically everybody from Buddy Hield over wanted him to throw it, and then him and the guy right behind him. Were, the guy behind him's like,
No.
Throw it that way. Throw it that way.
And that was, we always gave a cake to any of the people that came on our show in Summer League. But he was like really early on, right?
I think so, yeah.
Like, we hadn't given out that many cakes, is my point. It wasn't like the 40th cake and finally somebody threw it. I feel like it happened somewhat early in the run.
He was like third season, though, wasn't he?
Oh, was he?
Yeah, really? He was later on in the season, but it was definitely early in the run that year.
Oh, okay, maybe that's him.
I like how he says, you guys want some cake? And then he just starts picking gummy bears for himself, or gummy worms, or whatever they were on that cake.
I also love you. You're like, hey, we got to see the cake on camera. You're like trying to take it from him, trying to get the angle. Hey, it says Buddy Buckets on it. Hey.
Yeah, that was the fun part, coming up with what to put on there, wasn't it? You know,
it was fun for the first couple of years. Yeah. We started running out of things to put. What was the worst thing we put on a cake?
L.A. Cakers.
Is that Julius Randle?
Brilliant.
L.A. Cakers is good. I was going to say, Jabari Parker, number two.
Buckaroo! Yeah, didn't know what to put on.
I like that one. Yeah, it was always fun trying to get the angle of the camera.
Right.
Start sliding off the thing.
Yeah, not easy.
How much money do you think was spent / wasted on cakes at Summer League?
Well, $20 each. Yeah,
not cheap.
That's it? Yeah. I thought they'd be more.
No,
they're simple sheet cakes.
Slab cakes that you get at Costco or whatever.
A few $100.
Now, I shouldn't say like all were wasted, because some of them, some of the players would take them to like to their family or to like their teammates, and like, they just dig in a little bit.
These are like elite athletes who would be like, I don't need sugar or whatever. Mm-hmm. Buddy wanted those gummy worms.
Someone was like that. They were like, they weren't touching. I can't remember who it was, but I remember Julius Randle got upset. I think it was you, like, went to touch, and he's like, get your hands off me.
I could have sworn Brandon Ingram ate some. Like, he dug in because he said, I'm a little too skinny. You got to pack on some.
Yeah, yeah. That sounds familiar.
Couldn't find a clip, though.
Oh, tough. Yeah. It's out there somewhere.
It might have happened off camera.
Yeah,
I think
so. Well, one thing that did happen on camera was a very bizarre moment with our friend Kristen Ledlow. We'll get to that after the break, as well as the man who termed the coin, what? Who coined the term wedgie. Stay tuned.
This podcast is sponsored by BetterHelp Online Therapy. A lot of us will drop anything to go help someone we care about. We'll do anything for other people, but how often do we give ourselves the same treatment? I am absolutely guilty of this. I don't know how to carve out time for some self-care. And especially right now, it is a very, very, very good investment. That's it. I'm taking an Epsom salt bath tonight. This month, BetterHelp Online Therapy wants to remind you to take care of your most important relationship, the one you have with yourself. Whether it's hitting the gym, making time for a haircut, or trying therapy, you are your greatest asset. So invest the time and effort into yourself like you do for others. Trying therapy, it can be difficult to initiate. But once you've taken that first step, it gets easier. Let me help you take the plunge by pointing you in the right direction. BetterHelp is online therapy that offers video, phone, and even live chat sessions with your therapist, so you don't have to see anyone on camera if you don't want to. It's much more affordable than in-person therapy, and you can be matched with a therapist in under 48 hours. This podcast is sponsored by BetterHelp, and No Dunks listeners get 10% off their first month at betterhelp.com/nodunks. That's BETTERHELP.com/nodunks.
Things were a little slow in the Ellis household this morning because it was quite chilly. We even had some snow over the weekend here.
Magical.
Which meant a few extra hours in the beds in the morning under the covers there. So the hardest part of waking up this morning was just getting out of that bed because I have a Helix mattress as well.
What a brag.
I know. Now, I say it a lot, but about my favorite sponsorships of our show. But I mean it when I say Helix is number one on my power rankings because I get to experience it for basically 8 to 10 hours a day. Which is great. And just before the sponsorship came on board, we were looking for a new mattress. And I said, well, we may as well try this one. And now it's like, oh my God, absolute steal. A steal, I tell you. And listen, if you want a Helix mattress, you can go online and find out which one suits you best. Because I have a quiz that takes just 2 minutes to complete and matches your body type and sleep preferences to the perfect mattress for you. Why would you buy a mattress made for someone else? I mean, including your partner, of course.
Yeah.
Everybody's unique and Helix knows that, so they have several different mattress models to choose from. They've got your soft, your medium, your firm. Mattress is great for cooling you down if you sleep hot. Mattress is great for spinal alignment to prevent morning aches and pains, and even a Helix Plus mattress for plus-sized sleepers. So if you're looking for a mattress, take the quiz You order the mattress that's matched to you, and the mattress comes right to your door, shipped for free. You don't even need to go to a mattress store, and then you can do an unboxing like Tassie did there, which was like viral, wasn't it, Tassie?
Absolutely.
Like, yes, yes. Incredible.
Look it up.
Yeah.
Look it up.
Don't just take my word for it. Helix, number one in John Schumann. No, hang on.
John Schumann's power ratings?
Yeah, no. Best overall mattress of the 2020 and by GQ and Wired magazine. Helix has been recommended by multiple leading chiropractors and doctors of sleep medicine as a go-to solution for improving sleep. So it's got the stats to back up its claims here.
Right.
Just go to helix.com/nodunks, take their 2-minute sleep quiz, and they'll match you to a customized mattress that will give you the best sleep of your life. They have a 10-year warranty, and you get to try it out free for 100 nights risk-free, and they'll even pick it up for you if you don't love it. But no one's giving that back after 100 nights, I tell you, you're ordering the second one. Listen, Helix is offering up to $200 off all mattress orders and 2 free pillows for our listeners at helix.com/nodunks.
Well, we're into the new year by this point. One goal I got for myself this year is to re-qualify for Boston by trying to run about a 3-hour-ish marathon this summer. Oh boy. Got my kicks, got my training program, 16 weeks of running and yoga, swimming, hey, maybe a little cycling. And now I've got my favorite hydration product, Liquid IV, baby. One stick of Liquid IV in 16 ounces of water hydrates faster and more efficiently than water alone. And Liquid IV got some incredible hydration flavors. Watermelon, lemon lime, pina colada, and more. Variety is the spice of life, people. Early favorite in the Skeets Liquid IV rotation, strawberry. And this product really has come a part of my daily workout routine. I generally take one before run and sometimes one after, because Liquid IV is made with premium ingredients and it hits you with 3 times the electrolytes of traditional sports drinks. It just also has me drinking more water, and I always need that reminder. It's a win-win here. Keep the body and the mind sharp. So grab Liquid IV in bulk nationwide at Costco, or you can get 25% off when you go to liquidiv.com and use the code NODUNKS at checkout. That's 25% off anything you order when you use the promo code NODUNKS at liquidiv.com. Experience better hydration today at liquidiv.com. Promo code NODUNKS.
What do you think? Can I get 20?
I think you got 20 in you for sure. Good luck, buddy.
Thanks a lot, Kyle. Appreciate it, man.
You got it. You got it.
Here goes. 20. Kyle thinks I can do it. I think I can.
21. He's got 21.
21.
Come on.
All right.
MVP.
You coined the term wedgie. Do you remember when you first used it, if you heard it from somebody else?
No, it just happened one day. The ball got caught between the rim and the board, and I said, it's a wedgie.
Wedgie!
It just popped out of my mouth, like most things, without any thought at all. Just something crazy comes out of my mouth. And if people start repeating it back to me, I think, well, I guess that kind of works, so I'll use it again. And we haven't had one in a while. I'm kind of in remorse. I need a wedgie pretty badly.
I feel like we should have to hold our mics like this in this segment in honor of Ralph Lawler. But
the great Ralph Lawler. He says that he made that term up.
Just freestyled it.
I believe him.
I believe him, too. And I believe him because of how passionate he was. I asked him another question about it. I think we were at the Four Seasons Hotel.
Swanky.
Yeah. Well, the Clippers were staying there. I wasn't. I took a cab. It took a while. Anyways, he was so passionate about it. JD, can we roll that clip?
It's like you're the fifth starter. We're always in remorse when we don't have what you you'd fit right in on the show. Do you distinguish between different types of wedgies? Let's say like a DeAndre Jordan alley-oop wedgie. I mean, he's had some special ones. And, you know, there's some of those that are just lightly get tucked in there or really jam in there. Do you change your call depending on the wedgie?
No, it just whatever comes out of my mouth. I think a wedgie is a wedgie. You know, if you, everybody knows a good wedgie when they have one.
It's a million great lines. Yeah.
I know. I kind of, you know, squeezed him in, no pun intended, into the guest list because I didn't intend that. Because he wasn't in our studio. You know,
right.
He wasn't necessarily a guest. You guys didn't get to talk to him, but it was 2 minutes of gold. And it's the most infamous thing that we're known for in the NBA universe, the wedgie. And I do believe that he is the man that came up with that term. So I had to get in Ralph Lawler, great, on the call.
So much content, merchandise we've got out of it. It's just, you know, a wedgie.
Don't say that too much. I mean, he might want a little cut of this. What do you mean? We don't sell any shirts that say wedgie on it.
One thing that I think that you've gotten out of the show, Lee, is a genuine friendship with Kyle Korver. Can I say that?
I think so, yeah.
I think so, too.
Yeah. We live near each other. We've bumped into each other at a few social gatherings.
Oh.
We've talked some dad stuff, you know. But we've also talked some three-pointers, which is where it started, which was great, you know, because he was my first coach ever to try to win the three-point, or, you know, to score 20 points in the three-point shootout.
My first coach. You've had multiple coaches.
I was going to say, he came before Curry, though.
That's right. Right. Yeah, because he was down here, so the access was a little bit easier.
I understand why.
Yeah. He's great, though. Yeah, I've seen him sometimes, even in the morning, like he's wound down the window. Hey, buddy. I'm like, hey.
You ever blow corporate kisses to him?
Nah, probably would look a little bit weird if I was to start blowing kisses to another grown man. But, you know.
And you unfortunately never came through at the 20.
No.
After Coach Korver was helping you.
No, 19 twice is the closest I've gotten. So
he said 21, actually.
Yeah. I know.
You seemed taken aback when he said it. You're like, oh. On the clip, you're like, oh, okay, 20 is now where you want 21. Okay.
Yeah. If I remember correctly, during that shootout, I think I hit like my first like three or four shots with him too. It's kind of like, maybe I don't need help. I don't know.
Kristen Ledlow, probably the fifth starter. I mean, Brent Barry was on our show a ton. Kristen was pretty regular on our show.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to highlight this because I don't know if you guys remember this. It was a bizarre moment. I think the most bizarre moment in the history of our show.
What?
Wow.
Yeah.
That's saying something.
I know. We've had pickles on our show. Grown men dressed as pickles. What's another wild
man
one?
Man picked me up and ripped my underwear off.
Yeah,
I mean, that's pretty weird.
Yeah,
that's great. Can't wait to see that in part three. This one, it just came out of nowhere. Kristen's at a Boston Celtics game. She's doing a hit with us via satellite. And in comes Kelly from the Boston Tea Party Museum. And we're going to show you part of the clip. But it goes on and on and on. And we've got to get to commercial, Kelly. We've got to get to commercial. I know there was a panic in the studio. JD, roll Kristen and Kelly.
I emailed the Celtics and asked, could I get Kelly for the show? There must have been some sort of communication error because Olenek's out here shooting around and they sent my friend Kelly instead.
Oh!
This is Kelly.
Hello.
Of the Boston
Hi, Kelly.
Tea Party Museum, Kelly. A big, they're playing the colonial music for you. Yeah. It's a big week for you.
Hey, it's a huge week for us. Now, here we are in Boston, of course, with the historic Boston Celtics 17 championships. I know, that's huge, but that is not the only historic thing happening here in Boston. Tomorrow is the 242nd anniversary of the Boston Tea Party. And we are celebrating with a full-scale reenactment of the Tea Party. We march through the streets of Boston to the sound of the fife and drum. Then we go down to the waterfront where we will be dumping real East India Company tea into Boston Harbor to be involved in our
Kelly, how will the
incredible.
Celtics stop LeBron James?
Sorry, one more time.
They want to know how the Celtics plan to stop LeBron James. You and your friends learned how to stop the King.
That's
so.
True, yeah. So I would say to stop the King, you have to form an organized protest.
Last question here. We started our show in Canada. We moved from there. Do you look down upon us because we're part of the Commonwealth?
Good question.
A little bit, right?
Could she not hear us?
Your piece was definitely not working.
Yeah, I don't think so. It just keeps going. I can't hear them.
I don't know what else there is to say about that.
I'd forgotten about that clip.
Yeah. Well, I think Skeets nailed it. Wow.
They were handing out real East Indian tea.
Yeah. I'm literally shaking my head at one point. I can hear, like, rewatching that, I can hear Matt Austin in our ears.
Yeah, yeah.
So ask her about the game. Tell her we gotta go to commercial. Somebody take it back to the studio. I can hear it.
But we keep asking her questions.
Yeah, it's true.
Well, come on, man. It was the 242nd anniversary of the Boston Tea Party. Yeah, you have to commemorate it.
The protest, the King line, that was good.
Yeah.
One other thing that was good, Zach LaVine, obviously an incredible dunker. He rated one of your dunks, Lee. Let's take a watch.
We're going to show you one from Lee, the cupcake dunk.
Yeah.
Yeah, here we go. Doing some yoga. And blowing up. No.
Nope. It was those candles. It was those candles, you know, that you can't blow out. That's what it was. I think they set me up.
Look at Ellis.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes. E-dog there.
See, I like the attempt at the end with the blowing out the candle. That's a five.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, creativity.
Creativity at the end. Sticking with your dunk.
That's all right.
Sticking with it.
Wow. Even five was generous, I think, with that squad. I couldn't believe how hard it was to actually get up there and get close enough to blow it out. I couldn't do it. It was crazy. It was only on an 8-foot hoop, too.
I forgot in Summer League you had the
big sideburns.
The big sideburns.
I don't know why we were growing those.
We
as a group decided I was going to grow them. I don't remember why.
But. I don't remember us as a group deciding to do that. I think you were just like, I'm growing my side.
Yeah, maybe. It's sort of like.
And you were like, what do you guys think? And we're like, okay, whatever you want, man.
Because that wasn't even the year we dressed up as Elvis, was it?
I mean,
that would make a little more sense.
Maybe.
If you were going out your sideburns for the grand finale of us dressing up as Elvis, but I don't think so.
Nah, I don't know. I can't remember, but I remember the cupcake. The idea was great. I was like, yep, I'm gonna do this, and then I was like, oh my god, I can't even get close to it.
Can't believe you thought you would be able to do it. Like, what
and
an
8-foot rim
about?
You sort of think, you know, I'll be able to get right up to the rim and like, but
I don't think that. Yeah. I can jump and get my head to an 8-foot rim. You did eventually get it blown out, though. It just was a, you know, a 2-step process.
Did you actually blow it out, or did the candle like get
just
down close to the frosting? That's what I thought.
Maybe.
Yeah. No, that was totally that dunk. That was staged. I think Matty O might have been on a ladder and blew it out.
Oh, come on.
Because you definitely didn't do it.
Well, I think that was the same year that I jumped over Matt to the side to dunk over him.
Yeah, jumped over him. Just went around him. Oh, at least the dunk contest got better. Year after year, I think it progressed.
That was year two. Yeah. Year one, I was pretty bad. Year two, Lee didn't have his best. Year three, it all came together.
Yeah, year three was the most exciting competition. Yeah.
Well, maybe it'll all come together in part three of our three-part series here of our top 75 guests. Make sure you check out the other two parts. And to take us out, we can never get enough of people telling us that they love us. So here's Tristan Thompson.
Enjoy myself. I'm a champion. Enjoy myself. Oh, there it is. Thank you, guys. The starter is Toronto. Thank you, guys. I watch y'all, too. Y'all do a great job. I like that you ran the treadmill for the whole show. That's pretty amazing.
Thank you. Thank you.